Coco's keepers knew that she loved babies. So, because Coco didn't have any of her own, her trainer decided to celebrate her birthday by preparing a very special treat. Indeed, Coco's keepers couldn't wait to see her face when she looked into the box they'd prepared. After all, it was pretty much her dream gift. Hey, lovely people. I'm Scott Leffler from Wonderearth. Before we begin, make sure you smash the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for new amazing videos. This gorilla got the best birthday gift. The moment she saw inside the box will melt your heart. Coco's story, though, began July 4th, 1971. This was when San Francisco Zoo saw the birth of a western lowland gorilla called Hanabiko, a name meaning fireworks child. The gorilla was nicknamed Coco, and when she was just half a year old, she contracted a life-threatening disease. To be treated then, she had to be removed from her mom. After Coco recovered, she caught the attention of Stanford University's Francine Penny Patterson. Indeed, the psychology PhD student asked the zoo if she could work with the baby gorilla as part of a project. Fortunately, the zoo agreed, on the condition that she'd promised to spend 4 years in the ape's company. So Coco relocated to Stanford University with Patterson in 1974, and together with zoologist Dr. Ronald Cohn, Patterson worked with the gorilla daily. Their goal for Project Coco was, moreover, to see if apes could learn sign language. During the project, Patterson formed an unbreakable bond with Coco and became like a mother to her. The connection was also shared by Ndume and the late Michael, two other gorillas who joined the project. What's more, the apes' aptitude for sign language proved to be impressive. Today, Coco knows more than 1,000 signs and can understand over 2,000 English words. Michael, who passed away in the year 2000, was just as fluent, while Ndume also picked up signs from Coco and the human caregivers. Patterson told The Atlantic in August 2015 that because Coco had long been surrounded by language speakers, she understood some English from the beginning, she explained. She also had some signs when I arrived that she used without anybody prompting her, so I created new signs and asked questions. When we got our signs added to hers, she generalized them, Patterson added. Gorillas, it was discovered, make their own signs naturally. In fact, around 100 have so far been identified by researchers. Coco uses language at a similar level to that of a young child. Unlike small kids, however, she can grasp concepts like special events. Even a month before her birthday, she starts putting out some of these cards and birthday designs on them, Patterson said. Perhaps unsurprisingly, the extent of Coco's intelligence has been challenged, but the gorilla's extraordinary ability to communicate has brought her to international fame. She even has a number of celebrity friends, including Leonardo DiCaprio, Sting, and the late Robin Williams, whose passing caused Coco some sadness. It also seems that Coco is somewhat aware of her status, having used the sign for Queen to describe herself. It was a sign we almost never used, Patterson told The Atlantic. Coco understands that she's special because of all the attention she's had from professors and caregivers and the media. There's one thing, however, that no amount of fame can give Coco. Patterson explained that whenever asked the gorilla what she wanted for her birthday, she always replied with the sign for baby. Coco's caregivers knew that she occupies both animal and human worlds, so as a youngster, she'd often be given toy animals and dolls to play with. When she was 12, however, the gorilla was given a real kitten named All Ball to look after. All Ball, sadly, was run over 6 months later, and Coco marked her pet's passing with the signs for sad, cry, trouble, and frown. The gorilla has had several kittens since, though, including a red tabby called Lips Lipstick and Smokey, a gray kitty who lived for nearly 2 decades. Patterson's initial 4-year pledge to Coco has then turned into a 44-year relationship. So on July 4th, 2015, the great ape's 44th birthday, Mommy wanted to really mark the occasion. In fact, she gave Coco a box with something super special and super snuggly inside. This was the ultimate gift, a litter of kittens. And despite her huge size and strength, Coco proved to be a gentle giant. She was certainly eager to pick her new babies up, but she made sure that the kitties got used to her scent first before tickling their bellies with a single finger. Coco clearly loved her new little kitties. She even used the signs for cat and baby, which signaled to Patterson that she was more than happy to adopt them. She also signed to ask for one of her favorites, a kitty named Miss Gray, to be put on top of her head. A second kitty, Miss Black, couldn't wait to climb out and see her new adopted mommy. And throughout it all, Coco was a delight. She sat so still while they climbed all over her. This was clearly one very happy family. Patterson has largely achieved her goals in terms of Coco's use of sign language. Now then, her focus has shifted to great ape welfare in general. As for the kittens, well, in February 2016, Coco's website released a video showing that the kitties had all grown up. And yet, while they may now be fully fledged cats, they still enjoy spending time with their gorilla mom. Few things, it seems, are as good for a broody animal's well-being as a litter of kittens, this gorilla being a particularly cute case in point.